In this example, we will set up the basic infrastructure that must be in place to get autoscaling started for most applications. We will set up an Amazon EC2 application to be load balanced and autoscaled with a minimum and maximum number of one instance. However, when you create your actual website, you should follow the best practice of having sufficient instances across availability zones to survive the loss of any one availability zone. Additionally, increase your maximum number of instances to be greater than your minimum to make use of the autoscaling feature. We will define a single autoscaling policy to scale out by one when there is a change in capacity. Later, we will create a CloudWatch alarm to take action on the policy when the average CPU usage exceeds a threshold of 60% for 10 minutes. Autoscaling and Amazon CloudWatch work together to launch or terminate instances based on the policies that you create. In this example, we will use a publicly available Windows AMI running Microsoft Windows Server 2008 R2 and Microsoft Internet Information Services. First, we will create a launch configuration that specifies the type of EC2 instance that we want autoscaling to create. We will need to have our key pair file in the directory where we are creating our autoscaling group. At the command prompt, type as-create-launch-config and the name of the new configuration, which we will call MyLC, the image ID, for this example, we will use AMI-4BB57922, the instance type, which is an M1.large, our security group, Web App Security Group, and our key pair, MyKeyPair. Now we will create an autoscaling group that references this launch configuration. We will use two availability zones. This is a good practice for building fault-tolerant applications. If one availability zone experiences an outage, traffic will be routed to another availability zone. The number of instances that will be launched in the autoscaling group will be evenly distributed across the availability zones. At the command prompt, type as-create-auto-scaling-group. We will call our autoscaling group MyAutoscalingGroup. Pass it the launch configuration name, which is MyLC, and the availability zones US-East-1C and US-East-1B. Create a minimum size group of one instance and a maximum size group of one instance. Associate it with the load balancer that we've already created. A scaling policy tells autoscaling how to change the size of your application fleet in response to load changes. At the command prompt, type as-put-scaling-policy. We will call our scale-up policy MyScaleUp Policy. Pass it the name of the autoscaling group, MyAutoscalingGroup. We will increase the adjustment by one instance if there is a change in capacity. Specify a cooldown of 5 minutes or 300 seconds. Once the policy is created, autoscaling will return the policy information. In this example, we only created a scale-out policy. However, you normally would want to create a scale-in policy as well. Verify that your autoscaling group exists by using the as-describe-auto-scaling-groups command. Autoscaling returns a list of your current autoscaling groups. You can see that an instance has been created in the US-East-1B availability zone and that it is currently in service and healthy. For more information about autoscaling, see the Autoscaling Developer Guide.